was born, post office, named Hall, York County, the school there, and lived a normal life of a good, healthy boy till I was about 18 and one half years old. And then my father died very suddenly with a heart attack or stroke. Now, I had grown up in my father's shop, and I never served any apprenticeship because I just worked in the shop and Dad wanted me to and helped him like that. I said, where's the job? He said, Helen, that's in York County, about 5 miles from the Susquehanna on the Lincoln Highway. And I asked him what I was getting. He said, your board and a room, of course, and $3 of cash. So I went down at the appointed time, and I got there about probably 5 o'clock in the evening. It was nearly 4 years before I left. In going around, I had a brother that lived at New Salem a while, and I went up to visit there, and there was a young lady there that seemed to fit the scope. And afterwards, we got married nearly 2 years afterwards. And I didn't know what to do. The boss didn't think that he could employ me. I wanted the cash. I wanted the whole amount. Would have been about $7. No, I wanted $7.50, I believe. And then I'd rent my own house. And we'd keep house. But my brother and my father-in-law sort of urged me, or at least I was to go in business for myself. My father-in-law's slogan was that if you could earn that much for the other man, that he would pay you that much, then you might earn a little more, and then you'd have that for yourself. So we got married, and on the first day of September, we got married the 10th of August, 1902. And on the 1st September, in the same year, I had become acquainted with people who knew a place called Maytown in Lancaster County and who thought to be very good. My wife, her mother died and she was keeping house for her father. And she thought that she ought to remain with her father until the following spring. And then he would quit housekeeping, he was an old gentleman, and he'd move to the city of New York where some of his daughters lived and live with them. And my wife didn't come over to live with me until a few days in March of the following year. And her father made sail and did as he had thought he'd do. And I opened up a Honda shop, and I did think I was able to do the work, and apparently was, and lived there and improved my condition whenever I thought it was fit. Such things like selling bicycles and automobile tires. And I had a regular store then along with it. No grocery store on the hardware type. And then, in 1953, my wife died. And our former pastors, I was well acquainted with the former pastor's wife, and eight and about 8-9 months afterwards, I married her. And I continued in business until April 1957. Then I sold out lock, stock, and barrels, and we moved to a private home